Hi everyone, why INTJ are quiet? Because of our cognitive function, that's all. I am quiet because I have NI as dominant function. Our dominant function is the upper of who we are and is our default functioning. I talk only to say things which are essential, good, useful or true. I need a good reason to talk or a goal. Each word, each sentence, information we say can have repercussions, consequences on the future. A word have influence, good or bad, on the other person, on his mental health, also mental health, influence physical health, and the reverse too. We are all different, with different personality types, different way of thinking and perception, and also with different experience. A same word or situation can have a positive effect on a person, a negative effect on another person, or no effect on another person. I sort, compare the information, the word, try to find the best word to say, the most appropriate word to employ. A person can appear totally normal on the outside, but we can't know what's happened in the mind of a person. If the person has trauma, disorder, dysfunctioning, syndrome, the person can be hypersensitive, for example. As Frank GM say, statistically, if you speak less, you will say less dumb things in a long run. Less we speak, less we have chance to hurt someone or make him feel bad. Energy and time are important for me. I constantly processing information. There is always something to do, something to improve, or something to think. Always an idea. I never get bored, lonely. I am very aware of what happened around me. Light, sound, movement, energy. Very curious. Often want to know why on practically everything. I can be easily tired, physically, mentally, emotionally, and have nervous fatigue. I always process information, data, even when I think I don't. When I was younger and my parents told me, "You are not tired, you haven't done anything all day," no one can know how we feel. No one should invalidate the feeling of someone else. We all have different energy and different ways to use it and manage it. And we can see it from the outside, super calm from the outside, but inside it boils. It's like the water in surface. It happens nothing, but inside in depth. It's full of life and a lot of things are happening. I am calm because I recharge my energy. Even if I do nothing, just hearing what people say or see what they do take energy. I am very aware and pay attention to many things. I can be easily distracted because every piece of information or thing can make me think of something else. Listening and be concentrated on what people say take energy. I don't want to bother people. In my mind, I think each person has his own life, his own problem to solve, have to take care of their own health, well-being, mental and physique. I don't know what's going on other people's mind. I want to feel useful. If I feel useless, I can prefer to go elsewhere. People are also information themselves. Everything is an information or data, visible, invisible, concrete, abstract, thing, person. When someone says something, I try to understand why this person said this, or that word or sentence. I try to guess the why, the cause, or the consequence. What happened before that made this person say this, and imagine the future consequence that this can have on thing or people. Same with the behavior of someone, when the unconscious and conscious behavior don't match together, I try to understand why, because I know something wrong. I notice when someone's behavior change, comparing to how he behaves habitually, and same, I try to understand why. I try to be less weird as possible, observe them, to after adapt to them, I think to what I will say after, use the most appropriate or correct word, and the most appropriate behavior. Try to be perfect, to not act weird. I think to situation which happened before, and I can regret what I have said to a person. I can be deceived of myself. I think I could have done better, that I can be better and improve, that it was not perfect. I think to what people can think of me just by watching their eyes or behavior. And directly after think, I don't care of what people can think, because I know what I'm worth and I've done nothing wrong. That I always try to be correct. I analyze people, try to determine if we can connect or not, and on what point or subject. I can know in advance if we can get along each other or not. I link information to a person, what they like or not, what is important for them, find the original thing on them, what makes them unique. I try to guess the personality type of a person, to know their way of thinking, and if I know the personality of someone, I compare it to those who have the same type, and see on which point they can be similar or different, to reinforce or not the known pattern of this personality type. I am most of the time in my mind in another dimension between the past and the future. I imagine the worst case scenario and also the best. By expecting the worst or expecting nothing, I will never be deceived and surprised and happy when something good happens. I can think to the next hour, the next day or month, to the thing I want to do in the near or distant future. I have a lot of mental energy and feel that I have less physical energy. I try to find the best plan, solution or idea to spend less energy, time and money as possible. What is the best or most efficient thing to do? Taking into account many parameters, information. I can change and restructure my plan if there are new important information. I can imagine a future situation or conversation which will surely never happen, because nothing ever goes as I plan, between what we have in mind and the result in reality, it's always different. As Renaud Contini said in one of his videos, INFJ and perhaps INTJ, it's more that they are a temporal soul. They don't seem to exist in time. They sometimes seem as if they are belong to a different time, maybe called the future, maybe called an alternative reality. Mismatch of different temporality, eternal soul, or soul outside of time, but a soul that float in and out and never staying fixed. I think to what's happened in the past and imagine the future help to find the information, solve problems, understand, improve and not repeat the same mistake. I practically constantly analyze information, data, deconstruct and construct situation like a computer, my mind or brain defragment and update. As if I want to understand and resolve practically every situation, I think to a lot of things and overthink because I want to understand practically everything. If nothing happened on the outside, it's because something happened inside. So thanks for watching, have a good one, and see you in the next video.